What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another stimulus update and welcome to some good news. Today, the House voted on setting aside 2 hours of debate tomorrow, and then they will vote on the $1.9 trillion stimulus package that has been sent over from the Senate. This will begin tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. So the vote should be scheduled for right around 11 a.m., which means we will most likely see it pass. All reports indicate, as of right now, if everything goes as many people are expecting, we will most likely see this bill pass 219 to just 211. This is exactly or pretty much what happened today. There was 219 people that voted yes to move this bill forward and 211 that voted no. There was 210 that voted no. 209 of these people were Republicans, and only one was a Democrat that voted no. All 219 yeses were all Democrats. So most likely it will go the exact same way tomorrow morning as well. Now, according to the White House, the $1,400 stimulus checks will not have President Biden's signature on them. According to reports, they say this is not the look they are going for, and instead, the checks will be signed by a career official at the Bureau of Fiscal Service. So this is a different type of approach than what former President Donald Trump did when he wanted his signature on those checks. So we also expect President Biden is going to sign this $1.9 trillion stimulus package into law no later than Thursday afternoon. Some are saying that this could even happen tomorrow, or it could happen as early as tomorrow afternoon, but most are expecting this will probably happen sometime on Thursday, simply because the bill still has to be engrossed on parchment paper. I addressed this a couple days ago, and it's no different. Every single bill that goes to the president's desk has to be put on a special type of paper, and that is parchment paper. So, at the same time, Republicans, you know, yes, we still have to talk about Republicans. Republicans are still upset about the amount of money that is getting spent on this bill. They say that the $130 billion for schools is pointless and it's a waste of money, simply because, according to the Congressional Budget Office, they are saying that the $130 billion won't even be spent in the year 2021. They say this won't happen because the money from the previous rounds of stimulus hasn't even been spent yet. So yes, not just the funding for schools in the $900 billion stimulus package, no, not just that one, previous stimulus packages, the funding for schools hasn't even been passed. And so the Congressional Budget Office is estimating that this $130 billion for K-12 schools will not even be spent in the calendar year 2021. So Republicans are furious about this, saying it is just a waste of money. We're sending money, it's going to sit, and it's not going to do a thing. They also say that the money for state and local funding is a waste. Well, I'm pretty sure you expected this. Republicans have never been one for bailing out these blue states, even though some states that receive the money or are going to receive the money aren't technically a blue state. So that right now, yes, we do know New York and California are receiving more funding than any other states. These also have more people than most of the states. And so that's kind of what we're hearing. So I'm not getting into whether or not we need state and local government funding at this point. What all indications are telling us is that the majority of states are operating at a surplus. They aren't in any deficit. And because of this, those states will simply be putting their money into their rainy day funds. We know this is what's going to happen. This is what has happened before. So simply meaning the economy won't see much of these funds contributing back into the recovery. And so that's what Republicans are saying. It's kind of a waste of money. So here's what we know. Democrats aren't happy with this bill either. So yes, it's Republicans and Democrats aren't really happy. They didn't get their way. Nobody really got their way, or at least 100% of their way. What we are hearing is that Democrats say there should have been more for the unemployed. Even though we're going from $300 right over to another $300 per week as a bonus for an additional 21 weeks, they aren't happy. They say we should have went all the way through the end of September. They also say we should have added $400 per week, not $300. They also say there should have been more funding for the lowest income families. This is where they say the $15 minimum wage would have really came in handy. We also know that they do not believe that we should have had cuts to the $1,400 stimulus checks. And this is going to cut out about 15 million Americans that they say can now not contribute to the economic recovery. But even though Democrats are saying that, I just want to point this out. Again, this is my take, but even though these couples, these individuals are not going to get a $1,400 stimulus check, they can still contribute to the economic recovery. Chances are they're not getting a stimulus check because they make over the income threshold, that limit. So because of that, yes, they can still contribute to the economic recovery. It's just they cannot contribute with their $1,400 stimulus checks, which according to many reports, many surveys, the majority of Americans will not spend this $1,400 stimulus check because they don't know what's going to happen to the economy, and they do not know if we will ever see an additional stimulus check if the economy doesn't rebound like many people say it will. So based on everything that we're hearing at this point, not many people on either side of the aisle are happy with the way this bill actually turned out. President Biden is pretty ecstatic because it turned out pretty much exactly like he wanted. However, many people within Congress, our lawmakers, are saying that no, we needed more time to negotiate. However, we know that this Saturday is the deadline for the unemployment benefits, so this bill has to be signed into law before Saturday. And it's because of this that some experts are anticipating a huge infrastructure bill. Some say it's going to be anywhere from two to three trillion dollars. Progressives, especially in the House, are saying that no, this is going to be closer to $3 to $4 trillion. Some are saying that it's going to be up there. It will be up there. This will be the highest bill that Congress will ever pass. But what we do know right now is that including everything into the bills, everything into that we passed already, what we're seeing is that right now, they are saying that Republicans and Democrats will have to work together because Senator Joe Manchin will not agree to a budget reconciliation before Democrats try to get Republicans on board. If this is the case, and they have to get those 10 Senate votes from Republicans, it's going to be a very tall task. So, what we know right now is Republicans, their wish, their priority in all of this is just to keep the debt low. That's what we're hearing. We know this, but it's always good that for them to just reiterate exactly what they want. Well, even Senator Rick Scott, who's the senator from Florida, he had this to say today, and I quote, "This spending has got to stop. How are we even going to pay for all this additional spending?" Well, what experts are telling us, and we've been hearing this for about a month and a half, is that there are some ways to go about paying for this outside of increasing taxes. One of those ways, and we know President Biden is open to increasing taxes, especially for the wealthy, but one of the ways that we will pay for this, according to experts, is to make cuts to certain programs like Medicare and Social Security. And that's where experts simply ask, why would Democrats make these changes, provide all this additional debt, when they know that we will most likely have to make cuts to certain programs? We will most likely have to increase taxes, which the Biden administration has already said they're wanting to do. But why would they do this when they are supposedly trying to fix these programs and fix these issues? Why would President Biden run on giving additional boost, or the $200 boost per month, to Social Security recipients when he knows that we might have to make cuts to these programs, so an additional $200 is most likely not feasible? Well, right now this just doesn't look good to any of these programs, and this makes Republicans ask, why would we do this? Because it makes absolutely no sense. But right now, with everything, honestly, that has gone on over the past year and the crazy year of 2020 that we've had, not much makes sense at this point. There's a lot of stuff that has many questions behind it. What I can tell you, though, is that at least the IRS is trying to do right by the American people. And I know the IRS doing right by the American people, that seems like two things that shouldn't really go together, right? Well, here's what we know. Right now, the IRS is behind on their tax returns for the 2019 tax year. They started sending filers an additional interest payment if they were more than 45 days late on sending this return. Well, this is actually going to get even bigger. The IRS is expected that this is going to happen again. Last year, they sent out an additional $3 billion in interest payments. This year, they expect this will most likely increase. What they are saying is currently, stimulus checks will have a priority over refunding your tax return. So, in the processing of these tax returns. And if that's the case, many people are going to be very upset because a lot of people require this tax return at the end of the year to pay for the rest of the year or the next year. And that's going to become a big issue, especially if you don't get your tax return or your refund check for months or possibly even another year. So, what we know right now is that the IRS is currently behind by roughly 6.7 million tax returns from 2019 alone. That is according to the reports at the end of January. Well, what we do know is the IRS has fallen even further behind because the 2020 tax returns are already coming in. So, the IRS has stated that if you have to wait more than 45 days after the filing deadline, which is currently April 15th, which is normally what it is. If you have to wait more than 45 days after that, then they will send you an additional check for the interest payment based on how much you were supposed to receive. So, right now we do know things are starting to get put together from this stimulus package. We still don't know about payments from the child tax credit. We still don't know about how we can get the unemployment income tax waiver as far as, you know, the amount of money that you may have already paid. So we don't know all that stuff, but hopefully we're going to get some more guidance from the IRS, from the Biden administration, the White House, really anybody who would give us some more information. So as always, right now, as I always say, only time will tell how this turns out. Right now, all we can do is wait for more information and hope the information that they give us is actually correct. So, as always, as I know more, I promise I'll come back and share more. Consider subscribing so I can continue to keep you updated on everything that's going on. And I'll see you guys on the next one.